Gallup Web is a web interface in order to generate optimized code for different various programming languages. And its focus is on runtime performance as well as on robustness and numerical stability. And brand new is also our new visualization interface that we integrated, that we could integrate thanks to Steven. Steven did a really great work for the community, not only for us, but also for the whole community, because in the, let's say, before Steven times of the community, everybody used his own visualization tool, and now we have a great tool that we can use all together, and that's really nice for the community. Okay, so the base of Gallup Web is Gallup, which is a software, Java software, freely downloadable, in order also to visualize geometric algebra, but not in this very wonderful way Steven is doing it. We can compute also with geometric algebras of arbitrary dimension and signature, and generate also source code from descriptions of geometric algebra. And if somebody is, for instance, interested in developing a new interface, a new backend, Gallup is open source on GitHub. We have these possibilities. Okay, so this is a short look at the architecture of Gallup. First of all, we have our application, and then in order to integrate Gallup, we have to write a geometric algebra algorithm, and I will show you how this can be done. And then Gallup is symbolically simplifying, optimizing, and then we can generate source code for different programming languages and computing devices. Here you can see some examples. So how to describe the geometric algebra algorithm. We have our own notation. It is called Gallup script. Then we, as I told you, symbolically optimize the code. And the result is a language that we call GAP for geometric algebra parallelization programs. Means the principal result of Gallup is this programming language on a very low level with a lot of parallelism included. And I can show you some examples later on. Programming languages that we support are, for instance, C, C++, C++M, Java, OpenCL. GAPCO is an FPGA, a hardware design. For that, we also can compute, generate optimized code, MATLAB, Python, and a lot more. And since we support so many programming languages, sure, we also support many computing devices, from PC, tablets, smartphones, GPUs, HPC, whatever. What is Gallup in principle? It is not just another geometric algebra tool in the sense that it is a library for geometric algebra, but it is a tool in order to pre-compute as much as possible before runtime. Pre-compute not only on the level of products of geometric algebra, but of complete algorithms. And then at the runtime only very very simple operations have to be done. Means on the machine at runtime we only have a very small amount of computation which is needed, because much is already symbolically pre-computed, and this leads to fast implementations and, as a side effect, also to robust implementations. Means if we only have the most simple operations left at the end, during runtime, then we also do not have so much sources of numerical inaccuracies, and our experience is that based on Gallup, our implementations are normally very robust compared to conventional solutions. Okay, so I say Gallup is fast. I would like to convince you about that, and what is the reason for this speed of Gallup. In principle, we have two stages of optimization. So in the first step, we optimize on the level of products of geometric algebra. And then, in a second step, we optimize complete algorithms or parts of algorithms, because in this second step, there is we use internally maxima in the background, and or in Gallup, in a standalone software, you have to install maxima for that. And this is used for symbolic simplification. Do you have questions so far? No, so let's start with a short example in order to show you how the results are of some simple algorithms. This is an example. Some years ago, at the beach in the Netherlands, I had this idea. I was wondering, I'm standing at the beach, and what is in principle the horizon? How can I describe the horizon mathematically? Means, in principle, sure, the horizon is a circle, but how can I compute this? And this means I'm the observer P, and I have the Earth S visualized here, my eyes at the point P, the Earth, and what I'm seeing is the horizon here. How can I compute that? How can I compute that with conformal geometric algebra? The algebra, for instance, Hugo presented, and also Leo, and we could see it in different talks these days. Here's a summary of conformal geometric algebra. We have the main geometric objects: point, sphere, plane, circle, line, and point pair. And we have two different representations: the inner product null space representation and the outer product null space representation. You already saw it. Just to recap a bit, the point can be computed like this. This is a normal 3D point. The scalar product B before and as a linear combination of E infinity and E zero. The sphere can be computed based on the center point P minus half radius square E infinity, or in the OPNS representation as the outer product of four points. The plane can be computed based on the on its normal vector and the distance to the origin, or as the outer product of three points and the point at infinity, E0. Circle can be computed as the outer product, for instance, of two spheres or of a sphere and a plane, and in the IPNS representation as the outer product of three points. A line can be computed as the intersection of two planes, or with the help of two points and the outer product with E infinity. Point pair as the intersection, for instance, of three spheres, or as the outer product of two points. Okay, that's what we know, and how can we solve our problem then? The first question is, which sphere intersects with the sphere S at the horizon circle? So what would you say? Which sphere is that, Leo? Yes, it is a sphere in principle with a point P as a center point. And okay, and with a radius of this distance to the horizon, and the next question then is, what is the radius of this sphere K? And this can be done very, very easy in geometric algebra, because maybe you remember that the distance of two points can be described based on the inner product of two points. And this inner product, in principle, describes the distance squared. And this can be generalized to the inner product of point and sphere in a way that the inner product of a point and the sphere describes, in principle, the square of this distance. And this is exactly what we need for this application. And this means we can describe our sphere K based on this distance. For the formula of a sphere, we need radius square. So in principle, we need this expression. And you can easily see that this expression is the same as P plus inner product of sphere and point times E infinity. So it is very easy to describe this sphere K based on geometric algebra. And then we know we have now two spheres described. The intersection can be easily computed based on the outer product. And this means, okay, our circle C can be described as the outer product of S and K. And in principle, it is very easy to describe this circle then based on the sphere S and our observer point P. And I think this shows some very nice properties of geometric algebra. It is somehow very geometrically intuitive. It is very easy to, in my opinion, to work with geometric algebra. The expressions are very compact. If you consider to make this algorithm with linear algebra, you would need many, many formulas in order to describe that. And the next very interesting thing, the role of coordinates. Until now, we didn't think about any coordinates. Only if we are now interested in a very specific solution of this formula, then we have to consider also coordinates. But in order to develop the algorithm, we never had to think about coordinates until now. Okay, let's come back to our Gallup software. This algorithm can be described in this way in our language called Gallup script, and then we are able to generate optimized code for different programming languages for that. How is it working? P is defined with the function vec_n3 of three parameters. Vec_n3 takes x, y, and z Euclidean coordinates and generates a five-dimensional point of conformal geometric algebra. Then, in order to simplify it, the computation a bit, we say, okay, the center point of our Earth should be at the origin. Then we can easily say, okay, m equals to E0. And then we say, okay, our Earth S is defined based on the center point m minus half radius square times e infinity. This is a formula we just developed for the sphere K. And then we intersect both spheres, and the result is our circle C. One thing is important to mention in Gallup script is this question mark, because as I told you, we optimize complete algorithms, means we optimize all these five steps, but at the end we are interested in some result, and in this case we are interested not in the sphere, not in the sphere K, but only interested in the circle C, and this is indicated with a question mark. So we say Gallup, okay, this is our algorithm, but at the end interested are we only in this multivector C. Okay, and this is the result in the C language. As you remember, in conformal geometric algebra, the multivector is 32 dimensional. And what we are doing in principle is to compute all the coefficients of this 32 dimensional multivector. And many of the coefficients are zero. And since we are computing symbolically, we always know exactly what coefficient is zero. And we compute only the other ones that we really need. And here you can see as a comment always what is the meaning of this coefficient means. Here we computed, for instance, the coefficient for E1 wedge infinity. here for E1 wedge, E0 and so on. And what we can see is there are only very, very simple computations left at the end. We had a complicated, somehow complicated algorithm with outer products, with inner products, and so on. But at the end, with Gallop, we only have this very, very simple sums of products, and that's it. Okay, and I think you can imagine this way of optimizing leads to high runtime performance and robustness. We have some, I've written some two books currently about that. You can see them there. Foundations of Geometric Algebra Computing, where I describe the technology of Gallop, and also have some applications for robotics, computer vision, and computer graphics. And in the new book, Geometric Algebra, Introduction to Geometric Algebra Computing, I was going a step backward in order that I describe geometric algebra from a point of view of a two-dimensional conformal geometric algebra. Means in this algebra we can handle circles, lines, point pairs, and I describe geometric algebra, the operations, transformations, and so on, based on the on very simple examples that you can also use based on Gallop. Can play with Gallop and make your own experience with it. And also a nice remark, in the last chapter of this book, there is space-time algebra also described, what Anthony yesterday told us, and there's also a simple application how to handle, I think it was a simulation of some electromagnetic simulation. Okay, let's come now to Gallop Web. What is the difference to Gallop? Gallop Web is a new development of us in order to bring Gallop to the web. Means the only thing you have to know is a link, and then you can make everything without any installation of software, and now it runs in every browser, on PC, smartphone, whatever. Our current focus is on conformal geometric algebra, and what we did is we also included the PGA, the projective geometric algebra, that also Charles will present in the afternoon. We also integrated it. Okay. This is Gallop Web. This is a link for it. And my question is now, I would like to make a short example. What programming language would you prefer? C++? Okay. So I was inspired just in the talk before by Vincent, and would like to make a short example that he also presented to us. I would like to make the following computation. I have two vectors, u and v. But oh, what's the problem then? It's working? Yeah. Okay. Let's define two vectors, u and v, and compute the geometric product. Okay, that's a very, very short computation. No, sorry. Okay, u defined as u1 times e1 plus u2 times e2, and another vector with the same components. Oops. Okay, and then let's compute, or let's say w equals u geometric product v. Pardon? Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay, so, and if you would compute that, okay, nothing happens because we didn't mention what we really wanted to have computed, and sure, in this case, we are only interested in the result of W, and then we can push the run button, and then we have a connection to the internet, to our server, and the result is compiled. And the result is compiled, hopefully, already for C++ in a C++ way, or better to say, in a very simple C way. This is a very simple C function. What we can see is, we have the parameters u1, u2, v1, v2, and the resulting array. And what we really compute are the coefficients 0 and 6 of this multivector, of this 32-dimensional multivector. And we see that this is a linear combination of a scalar and E1 wedge E2, and these are the symbolic computations for that. Okay, this is the principle of Galop in order to generate optimized code of our algorithm. Sure, this was a very simple one, but they can also be a bit bit more complicated. Okay, so this was the principle how to generate optimized code. What we optionally integrated, as I told you, is now the visualization, the Ganja visualization, and for that we do not need only the real computation, but also some information what we would like to visualize. We need two extra fields for this visualization, and in one field we have to describe our variables, because as you just saw, our algorithm is described with some variables, u1, u2 in our example, and these have to be concrete values if you want to visualize. And we also have to say in a second field which multi-vector should be visualized in which color. So we can use blue, red, green, whatever, and in this way say which multi-vector should be visualized. Okay, we also have to consider, as you know, we have these two representations, IPNS and OPNS representation. Gansha is visualizing objects in the OPNS representation. Means if we compute an object based on the IPNS representation, then we have to dualize it before visualizing it with Gansha. Okay, this is a short example for Mathematica, and it generates code for Mathematica as well as the visualization. This is a short part of the generated code for Mathematica. Maybe we should look a bit at the algorithm. What did we compute in principle in this example? Okay, we created points based on the coefficients, the 3D coefficients of the points. Create point is another possibility in order to generate a conformal point. And then we compute three spheres, S1, S2, S3, based on some radius. And here we compute the intersection of these three spheres. And this is what we just saw in the visualization. Means here we define the coefficients of our points, A1, A2, A3, and so on, as well as each radius. And here we say, okay, the sphere 1 should be visualized in blue, sphere 2 in red, and so on. And this is a final result then. Okay. Let's show you another example. This is specifically a Galop for Gansha JS. So in principle, we compute JavaScript code of Gansha. And I can make a very, very simple example because as you can see, no. It is, sorry, I have to change again. Okay, what I just did was we have the possibility to select some sample scripts, and I selected create simple sphere. And this was the result. And if I push the run button, then this very simple script is evaluated, and the result is shown as a visualization. Okay, this is normal Gansha, and you, if somebody is interested, also in the JavaScript code, that's the JavaScript code for Gansha, which we generated. Okay, and then we can go back and edit our current script. And okay, as I told you, with Galop script, we have the possibility to change colors, for instance. Let's make this sphere, for instance, green. And let it run, and then we will see, okay, the sphere will be green. only to show you how the handling is okay. This is green now. But we also have some more interesting examples. Here, for instance, here we define our concrete values of an algorithm in the second part, and at the end we define which multivector should be visualized in what color. Let's look what this algorithm is doing in principle. We see, okay, this is a conformal point minus half radius square e infinity. This is a sphere. Then two additional points. Here we compute the multivector R, defined as the outer product of O, L, and infinity. Means, in principle, this is a line based on these two points. And then we compute the point pair as the intersection of this line and the sphere. And in this algorithm, we are only interested in whether there is an intersection of line and sphere, because based on the inner product of the point pair, we can decide based on the sign whether we have a real intersection or not. Okay. We can also let this run, and then the visualization is generated. Means here we only generate code for Gansha, but not for any other programming language, but we can use this example sure also there. Here you can see the computed points, the line in green and the sphere in yellow. And let's look how we defined it. Okay, magenta, O and L, these two points in green. R means the line that we computed, and in yellow, the sphere. Okay. This was one example. Another example is to compute a sphere based on four points. This is done in this algorithm, where we compute four points with these three-dimensional coefficients, and then compute the outer product of these four points, and the result is a sphere S. Here in this table you can also see all what we did here. Means create point is what happens here. We have a three-dimensional point and compute the conformal point, and the outer product of four points is described here. Means this is the outer product representation of a sphere. And then we say, okay, the points should be described, shown in magenta, and the sphere as in green color. Okay, and then we will see that the corresponding visualization is computed. Okay. Do you have any questions concerning these examples? No? Okay, so then let's go back. Does it work? Yeah. Okay, what we just saw was Gallup Web for Ganja. Let's look at some examples now for another programming language. Again, C++ or another MATLAB. Okay, then let's generate MATLAB code. And again, we have some sample Gallup scripts. For instance, here we can compute the center of a sphere, also defined based on 4 points. This is in principle what we just did for Ganja. Here for the generation of optimized MATLAB code, we do not need the concrete values we would like to compute, but we want to have it variable. Means here we describe 4 points, in this example not based on some predefined function, but based on the coefficients for E1, E2, E3 and E infinity. Coefficient of E0 is always 1. Then we can compute the outer product as we just did in our Ganja example. And here you can see then some possibilities that we have in order to optimize our code further. We have this specific pragma output where we can say we are interested only in the coefficients of E1, E2 and E3 of the multivector C. In this case, we then normalize our sphere because this expression hasn't been really normalized. This is why we normalize it. And then if we look how a sphere is defined in the inner product null space, we see that the first three coefficients E1, E2, E3, they describe the center point. And this is why, okay, with normalized S, we compute a sphere where we easily can extract only the E1, E2, E3 coefficient, and that's all what we are interested in, because all other coefficients do not have to be computed. And if we look at the MATLAB code now, we should see only the computations then for E1, E2 and E3. Okay, and this is done here. Okay, the formula is now a bit complicated, but it computes a lot. So based on 4 points describing a sphere, we now compute the center point of it. And here with this comments, you can see this is a computation for the E1 component, for the E2 component, and for the E3 component. Okay, that's Gallup as it was some weeks ago, but now we also have included the visualization of Steven. And this is why I would like to show you an example now, including also visualization. So sure, this helps if you develop your algorithm and want to be sure, is it really what I want to have? Then we now have the possibility also to check whether our algorithm is doing what it shall do. And okay, this is our algorithm that we would like to optimize. And as I told you, we have these two additional fields now. We can describe our discrete values of the variables, and we can say additionally what we would like to have visualized in which color. So if we look at our algorithm, okay, what is done here? Again, we are computing spheres and the intersection of the spheres resulting in a point pair. And now we can optimize this code and at the same time see the visualization whether this algorithm is really doing what we would like to have. Okay, this is now the new MATLAB function. You can see all the parameters needed for this function, and you can see all the computations of all the non-zero coefficients that we have to compute in order to what was the result, a point pair in this case. And here we can also see the visualization, and okay, it looks fine. It seems we did not visualize the point pair. Let's look why. Okay, we didn't visualize it, so we can edit. Currently we visualize sphere 1 in blue, sphere 2 in red, sphere 3 in green, and now we can add in some other color. Let's take black, for instance. The point pair. Sure, I have to take the right name. Dual PP4. And then also this point pair, hopefully, will be visualized. No. Was it OPNS? Maybe we should take. I will try it. PP4. Because as I told you, it is always important to know, is my multivector described in OPNS or okay. It's inside the sphere, yes. It is then a problem, but I think in principle you understood how you should manage that. Some short remark. On this web page, there is also a PDF available. So if you are not sure for something, it is a very short PDF with all the notations and everything you need in order to program. And also the example that I just showed are included in this. Okay. Okay, as I mentioned in the beginning, GalopWeb is focused currently on conformal geometric algebra, but we also included PGA, projective geometric algebra, and we did it in a way which is presented in a document on an archive. I think I should also, okay, this is, yes, this is a link of this archive where it is written how we use PGA inside of PGA. And here's a simple example. Then we have some specific functions in order to handle objects of PGA inside of conformal geometric algebra. And the big advantage is that we have we can use the benefits of both then, because you can start with PGA, with projective geometric algebra, where lines and planes are the basic geometric objects. But if you would be interested after some time also to handle spheres, circles and so on in a very simple way, that's very easy to do then. Okay, and this is, for instance, generated Python code for that and the corresponding visualization. Okay, do you have any questions so far? If not, then I would like to point you to conferences where we focus on geometric algebra in a workshop or as a complete conference. In Geneva this year in June, at the Computer Graphics International Conference, there will be a so-called Engage workshop. It is short for something with GA. I do not know exactly what it means. And next year, there will be the AGATSI conference in Brno in the Czech Republic, also with a focus. This is a conference specific with a focus on geometric algebra. It will be beginning of September next year. And if you are interested also for the other conference, on the slides you can find a link. And there is already also for this conference next year some information, what is the focus on, what is a committee, and so on. Okay. And in principle, this concludes my talk. I hope I could convince you that it is very easy to work with this tool, and I hope that you will try it by yourself, and wish you good luck, and would like to thank you for the attention. Thank you very much.